Yo, what is good, ladies and gentlemen? I hope everyone had a smooth time during the holidays. My name is Rye, and welcome back to the channel. And today, we'll be talking about Dragon Ball FighterZ. So after the release of Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, a lot of fans didn't know if we were getting more content for the game. But just recently, about like 12 days ago, Bandai actually dropped a trailer for a new DLC character, and that is Lab Coat 21. Now, a lot of fans had a lot of mixed feelings about having another 21 in the game, but actually, I was pretty excited to have her, because I always wanted Lab Coat 21 in the game from the get-go. I like her design, I thought she was pretty dope. And that also gives me hope that Arxis might add some other characters in the game. And I really hope they do, because like this game's really like, it hasn't died out yet. A lot of people still play the game. The game's still very enjoyable, although you have like obnoxious characters like Vegito, Gogeta, UI, all these other characters, you know. As obnoxious as they are, I still love those characters, and I really like, there's so much more they can add, you know what I'm saying? So in the event that Dragon Ball FighterZ does get a Season 4, here's my Dragon Ball FighterZ Season 4 wishlist. And I feel like a lot of these picks have a very good chance of getting in because there's a lot of fan favorites. I think these characters are dope as fuck. A few might be a little woozy here and there, but yeah, man. Enough rambling. Without further ado, let's hop right into this thing, man. Let's get it. Starting the list off strong, we have the kind-hearted warrior from the future and Trunks' mentor, the one and only Future Gohan. Now, if there is a Season 4 for Dragon Ball FighterZ, there is no way in hell that Future Gohan is not getting his name. Honestly, I prefer if he had one arm, but I trust that that's gonna make the character sick as fuck regardless if he has one arm or two. One thing I really want Gohan to have this moveset would probably be a barrier, just like what Android 17 and 18 have. As you already know, barriers are already strong defensive options, and I wouldn't mind Gohan having one to protect himself and his team. Now, I couldn't think of a cool level 1 Gohan would have before level 3. That'd be really sick if they gave him like something that Team Gohan has. You know how his level 3 is like probably some Kamehameha, huh? Now, imagine if they're like, let's see, I'm gonna call it Future Kamehameha or some shit like that. I know it sounds really corny, but I'm gonna roll with it. But yeah, I think that shit would be dope. I'd be cool if he did that, and in the background, he had like all his fallen comrades, like Piccolo, Vegeta, you know, all them, the Z fighters. I think that would be sick as hell. But to top it all off, I really want to know is Future Gohan's interactions with other characters. I want to know how Future Gohan feels when he sees that Trunks actually turn out to be a fine warrior and save the future. I want to know how Future Gohan feels when he sees Piccolo and Goku again. Now, I know most of these probably very emotional, but small stuff like that really satisfy me. I want to know how Future Gohan feels about Great Saiyan and how Videl feel about Future Gohan. And to top it all off, I want to see the interaction between Future Gohan and the androids. That including Cell, 17, 18, 16, 21. I feel like the interaction would be very tense and interesting, you know? But yeah, man. And one more thing I would like to add. I would love a dramatic finish with Future Gohan and Android, of course, on Destroy West City or the Day 1 and the Night 1, whatever. I think that'd be really dope. And I hope they add it. So yeah, that's Future Gohan. I hope he gets added in the game.
Are you feeling angry? Humiliated? Is that it? Fool! You don't know how humiliated it is!
Next up, we have the return of the cold and ruthless Saiyan Prince, Majin Vegeta. Now, I'm not gonna lie, half this list is probably gonna be filled with Saiyans, and a lot of you probably gonna complain about having too many Goku's and Vegeta's, but come on, man, how can we not have Majin Vegeta yet? He is like, I think he's peak Vegeta, like, he is the hardest Vegeta to come out of Dragon Ball. Now, the first two things I want them to add for Majin Vegeta would be an intro with Goku and Vegeta where they both power up before they start fighting. I feel like they definitely need that. I feel like we need more intros. And another thing I want them to add is the dramatic finish with Majin Buu, where he blows himself up. I feel like those two things are very key, and you need those in the game if they add Majin Vegeta. Those two things are vital. But yeah, man, next though I'll probably add is Ayo. Yo, Vegeta, can I finish, bro? Like, bro, you stay doing this shit, bro. Come on. Sorry about that. I had to let Vegeta finish. But for level 1, I think a cool level 1 for Vegeta would be when he, like, shoots a key blast at Majin Buu. He like points his two fingers up and powers up. I'll throw a picture up here to show you what I'm talking about. But yeah, I feel like that would be a cool level one. And then honestly, for level three, there's not many options, to be honest. Honestly, I think the best one would be another Final Flash, because that's all he really uses when he fights Goku. So yeah, I think a Final Flash for level three, and then for his another level three, like how Android 16 has, is when he blows himself up and he's like the last character or something like that. I think that'd be pretty solid. So yeah, I think that's it for Majin Vegeta. I really hope they add him, because I really want to play him. One of my favorite characters throughout the entire Dragon Ball saga. And yeah, man, that's Majin Vegeta. Next is a warrior from Universe 6, born and raised in Planet Sidala, and the humble Saiyan, Kaba. Now, I'm pretty amazed that Kaba hasn't been in the game from the start. I feel like he deserved a spot from the starting roster, and unfortunately he's been overshadowed by a lot of characters, and I don't really think he has that big of a shot to get into Season 4, unfortunately, but I'm still going to hope and dream that he can get in. Hopefully he does. And yeah, man. Now, if they did add Kaba, I'd probably want him to be a Super Saiyan 2, since that's like his strongest transformation. And I would love to see the interactions he's had between all the other characters, like Vegeta, how he talks to Kefla, Hits, Frieza. I feel like interactions would be very entertaining. And I always wanted to run a Universe 6 squad of Hit, Kefla, and Kaba. But like I said, I don't think he has that big of a shot to get in the game. And I don't think a lot of fans want him, so he probably wouldn't sell that much. But yeah, if he were to get in the game, I think a solid level 1 would be his consecutive key blast, like when you're shooting his key blast at Vegeta. I feel like that would be a solid level 1. And then for level 3, I think his Gallic Gun would be perfect for level 3. But yeah, man, Kaba does make him the game. I'll probably main him, because like I said, he's one of my favorite characters from Super, next to Hit and Kefla. So yeah, hopefully he gets in, and yeah, Kaba. And now we made it to the final character that I want to make in Season 4. But before we show that real quick, I'm going to show the honorable mentions of characters I wouldn't mind or be upset seeing in Season 4. Now, first up in our honorable mention would be Bojack. And I think Bojack would be a sick character if they added him. I would love him to have like a playstyle like he fights by himself, but also have like a Ganyu type playstyle where his gang members also help him fight. But that would be super sick. And yeah, man, Bojack made in the game, that would be super sick. I wouldn't mind at all. Another character I wouldn't mind having would be Android 13. I'd be super dope if they added like full power Android 13 when he has blue skin. Or actually, I wouldn't mind if they had added the country one either. But yeah, I feel like a lot of people forget about Android 13, and I feel like he deserves a spot in the game. His moveset would be super dope, and I think his interactions would be solid. And yeah, Android 13 would be pretty solid, my book. And I also think it would be sick if they added a dramatic finish with Goku and Android 13, where Goku like absorbs the spear bomb and one-shots 13. But of course we need like a glacier map for that, but I'm getting to that actually, so stay tuned. Another character that I really actually want would be Goten and Trunks. And I would love them to have like a playstyle like Android 17 and 18, where 18 like calls out 17 on me. So imagine Goten like fighting and Trunks comes out. And I would love you can like alternate between the characters, like say, you know how Videl, like you can pick between her pigtails or her other hairstyle. That'd be dope if you can like swap between Trunks and Goten and pick who you want to be. And for the level 3, I would love them to do like, you know how they fought Bio Broly, they were like hitting him a bunch, then like they did a bunch of key blasts. I think they did a Kamehameha or something like that. I think that'd be super dope and sick, so yeah. Gotenks is cool, but I feel like I like Goten and Trunks when they're just like themselves, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, if they add that in the game, that would be super dope. It's a long shot, but I wouldn't mind if they got dropped off. So yeah. And when I said dropped off, I mean like if they come to the game. So just had to clarify. And now we're down to our last honorable mention. And the last character I wouldn't mind adding would be Omega Shenron. Now, I'm actually very surprised that Omega Shenron didn't make it to Dragon Ball FighterZ Season 3. But since they added Gogeta, I feel like they gotta add Omega Shenron now, you know what I mean? And I feel like this should be like a dramatic finish or something like that, where he does Big Bang Kamehameha and like obliterates him. I feel like that'd be super dope. Also, I'd love to see how Omega Shenron talks to like Beerus, because you know they're kind of like he's on some god destruction type vibe, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, man, I think that'd be pretty dope, and I wouldn't mind at all if he got dropped off in the game. So, yeah, Omega Shenron. So now that we got all the honorable mentions out of the way for characters, I'll also like to add two more things I think the game really needs, and the fan base will probably really enjoy the devs added to the game. And first one being new stages. There's so many new stages that the game could have, you know what I'm saying? So that'll be dope if they add like a glacier map, if they added Kame House, Hyperbolic Time Chamber, Kami's Lookout. There's so many different stages that they can add, and also with those stages there can be a lot of dramatic finishes, you know what I'm saying? So that's just an idea. Another thing I wish they would add would be new skins for characters. That'll be super dope if I can pick Goku and like rock his jar jacket, you know what I'm saying? Or I can be Super Saiyan God Goku with the blue hair force and have like his shirtless gi, you know what I'm talking about, where he's sleeveless and has the blue kicks. That fit is hard. Or I can be Vegeta when he has like the gray fit. Or I can be Vegeta's Blue Saga fit, you know what I'm saying? So there's so many different skins out there that if they add in the game, I feel like they take the game to the next level, you know what I'm saying? So yeah. But now down to the final character that I actually really want in the game. And yeah, man, let's get right into it. And the final character I want to be added to Dragon Ball FighterZ Season 4 is Super Buu. Now, I don't care if it's Buuhan, I don't care if it's Buu Tanks, I don't care if it's Buu Piccolo. Just please give me Super Buu, man. Like, he's, I feel like, one of the hardest villains to come out of Dragon Ball. And I like his design. His design's super sick. And I think it would be really cool if, like, he had, like, a baby-type ability where he defeats his opponent and, like, he can take their outfit and, like, absorb them. And then, like, he gets their abilities. I feel like that would be so, so sick. I thought it would be super raw. And honestly, I'm not sure why, but I feel like a lot of people sleep on Super Buu. Like, people overlook him for, like, Kid Buu and then Majin Buu. Like, I feel like Super Buu deserved to be in the game from the start. Because, like, he is, in my opinion, he's the best Buu. Like, he's, although he might be, like, a little, he has, like, anger issues and stuff, but he can actually be smart sometimes, you know what I'm saying? Unlike the other Buus. Like, Majin Buu is just, he's just an idiot, Loki. And then Kid Buu is just, like, destructive and just, like, wild and crazy, like, unrestrained. But Super Buu actually be thinking sometimes, you know what I'm saying? So I feel like he's, like, the dopest Buu and the best Buu, in my opinion, of course. So for level 1, I feel like a good level 1 would be, I know Kid Buu already has it, but, like, when he does, like, his extinction attack where, like, he shoots a bunch of Ki Blasts. You know when he shot the Ki Blast and, like, eliminated A1 from Earth, all the humans? I feel like that'd be super dope, level 1. And for his level 2, I feel like he should have two. One where he absorbs his opponent, and then two where he does, like, you know when he threw, like, this big Ki Blast, like, Eons of Destruction, he said, or something like that? He threw it at Vegeta, and Vegeta, like, kicked it back at him. It's kind of like Kid Boosting, like, the big ball. That would be super sick for level 3. So, yeah, man, if Super Buu got added, I would be really, really pleased. And I'll run a team with him, like Frieza, Cell, and then Super Buu. I feel like that would be a super sick team. Although the Sand Tree might be bad, because, like, Frieza's dog shit. We're not going to talk about that. But yeah, man, Super Buu got added, I'll be geeked. So yeah, that's my list, and yeah. So yeah, man, there you have it. Those are the characters I would love to see in Dragon Ball FighterZ Season 4. I must say, sorry about the video quality. I'm still very new to making videos, if that wasn't obvious already. So I apologize if the video quality is really bad and the presentation was really garbage. And I do plan on improving, obviously, when I keep making more videos and stuff like this. But sorry in advance if my video is really bad. I'll take any criticism, so please let me know if it's what I can improve on, what I can work on, you know what I'm saying? Much appreciated. But yeah, man, I hope y'all looking forward to Lab Code 21. And I must say, I would not be surprised if Android 21 got revealed in a new Dragon Ball Super movie. If she got made canon, I would be so geeked, bro. I'll be so happy. Like, I feel like she deserves to be canon, you know what I'm saying? I feel like they're gonna try to make an effort to. That's just my headcanon, but hey, man, that would be super sick if they did that. But yeah, man, let me know what characters you guys want to see in Dragon Ball FighterZ Season 4, if there is one. And yeah, man, I can't wait to run Lab Code 21 and FighterZ and get smacked by Vegito, Gogeta, and UI like I always do. But she's a super dope character, and I can't wait to test her out, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, until next time, I'll catch y'all later, bro. Hope y'all enjoyed the video, and yeah, stay up. Later.